Good morning, brothers and sisters. Welcome to the Minor Basilica of Our Lady of the Rosary of Manaoag. Today is Monday, in the second week in Ordinary Time. We will now have the morning prayer of the Church, integrated with the celebration of the Holy Mass. We invite you to actively participate in our prayers. Please stand.
Lord, open my lips,
and my mouth shall declare your praise.
Come, let us sing joyful songs to the Lord.
Come, let us sing joyful songs to the Lord.
Cry out with joy to the Lord, all the earth. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before him, singing for joy.
Come let us sing joyful songs to the Lord.
Know that he, the Lord, is God. He made us, we belong to him. We are his people, the sheep of his flock.
Come, let us sing joyful songs to the Lord.
Go within his gates, giving thanks. Enter his courts with songs of praise. Give thanks to him and bless his name.
Come, let us sing joyful songs to the Lord.
Indeed, how good is the Lord, eternal his merciful love. He is faithful from age to age.
Come, let us sing joyful songs to the Lord.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Come, let us sing joyful songs to the Lord.
Please be seated.
When will I come to the end of my pilgrimage and enter the presence of God? Like the deer that yearns for running streams, so my soul is yearning for you, my God.
My soul is thirsting for God, the God of my life. When can I enter and see the face of God?
My tears have become my bread by night, by day, as I hear it said all the day long, where is your God?
These things will I remember as I poured out my soul, how I would lead the rejoicing crowd into the house of God. Amid cries of gladness and thanksgiving, the throng wild with joy.
Why are you cast down, my soul? Why groan within me? Hope in God, I will praise him still, my Savior and my God.
My soul is cast down within me as I think of you, from the country of Jordan and Mount Hermon, from the hill of Mizar.
Deep is calling on deep in the roar of waters. Your torrents and all your waves swept over me.
By day the Lord will send his loving kindness. By night I will sing to him, praise the God of my life.
I will say to God, my rock, why have you forgotten me? Why do I go mourning, oppressed by the foe?
With cries that pierce me to the heart, my enemies revile me, saying to me all the day long, where is your God?
Why are you cast down, my soul? Why groan within me? Hope in God, I will praise him still, my Savior and my God.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Lord, show us the radiance of your mercy. Come to our aid, O God of the universe, and put all the nations in dread of you. Raise your hand against the heathen, that they may realize your power.
As you have used to show them your holiness, so now use them to show us your glory. Thus they will know, as we know, that there is no God but you.
Give new signs and work new wonders. Show forth the splendor of your right hand and arm.
Gather all the tribes of Jacob, that they may inherit the land as of old. Show mercy to the people called by your name, Israel, whom you name your firstborn.
Take pity on your holy city, Jerusalem, your dwelling place. Fill Zion with your majesty, your temple with your glory.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
The vaults of heaven ring with your praise, O Lord. The heavens proclaim the glory of God, and the firmament shows forth the work of his hands. Day unto day takes up the story, and night unto night makes known the message.
No speech, no word, no voice is heard. Yet their span extends to all the earth, their words to the utmost bounds of the world.
There he has placed a tent for the sun. It comes forth like a bridegroom coming from his tent, rejoices like a champion to run its course.
At the end of the sky is the rising of the sun. To the furthest end of the sky is its course. There is nothing concealed from its burning heat.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Please stand.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, direct our actions according to your good pleasure, that in the name of your beloved Son, we may abound in good works. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
Our reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, every high priest is taken from among men, and made the representative before God to offer gifts and sacrifices for sins. He is able to deal patiently with the ignorant and erring, for he himself is beset by weakness, and so, for this reason, must make sin offerings for himself, as well as for the people. No one takes this honor upon himself, but only when called by God, just as Aaron was. In the same way, it was not Christ who glorified himself in becoming high priest, but rather the one who said to him, "You are my son. This day I have begotten you." Just as he says in another place, "You are a priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek." In the days when he was in the flesh, he offered prayers and supplications with loud cries and tears to the one who was able to save him from death. And he was heard because of his reverence. Son though he was, he learned obedience from what he suffered. And when he was made perfect, he became the source of eternal salvation for all who obey him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You are priests forever in the line of Melchizedek.
You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek.
The Lord said to my Lord, "Sit at my right hand till I make your enemies your footstool."
You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek.
The scepter of your power the Lord will stretch forth from Zion. Rule in the midst of your enemies.
You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek.
Yours is princely power in the day of your birth, in holy splendor. Before the day star, like the dew, I have begotten you.
You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek.
The Lord has sworn and he will not repent. You are a priest forever according to the order of Melchizedek.
You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek. Please stand.
The Word of God is living and effective, able to discern reflection and thoughts of the heart.
Alleluia, 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 Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The disciples of John and of the Pharisees were accustomed to fast. People came to Jesus and objected, "Why do the disciples of John and the disciples of the Pharisees fast, but your disciples do not fast?" Jesus answered them, "Can the wedding guests fast while the bridegroom is with them? As long as they have the bridegroom with them, they cannot fast. But the days will come when the bridegroom is taken away from them, and they will fast on that day. No one sews a piece of unshrunken cloth on an old cloak. If he does, its fullness pulls away. The new from the old, and the tears gets worse. Likewise, no one pours new wine into the old wine skins. Otherwise, the wine will burst the skins, and both the wine and the skins are ruined. Rather, new wine is poured into the fresh white skins." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Kindly be seated.
Welcome po sa Minor Basilica of Our Lady of the Rosary of Manaoag. Marami po ngayon ang gustong mag-diet dahil natapos po ang Kapaskuhan sa dami po ng kinain nating lechon noong nakaraang Pasko. At nung sa dami ng mga reunion at Christmas parties na naatinan natin, ang daming kolesterol na naipon sa ating katawan. Kaya maraming gustong mag-diet. Ano po? Siguro din dahil epekto rin ng quarantine, marami po sa atin matagal nakaupo dahil sa kanilang mga online classes, sa mga Zoom meetings nila. Marami nakaupo, kaya medyo bumibigat tayo, lumalaki. Ano po? Kaya naman ngayon, maraming gustong magbawas. Kaya makikita po natin sa mga social networking sites natin, sa mga social media natin, may mga kaibigan tayo kamag-anak, mga nagpo-post kung paano sila na-achieve nila ang kanilang weight loss dream. No? Kasi kailangan din ito ng self-discipline and self-determination. Ang iba, nagda-diet for health reason. Kasi yung iba, mataas po ang kanilang sugar at kanilang kolesterol. So, kailangan pababain. Nagda-diet sila. Pero ang dieting and fasting, magkaiba po yan. Ano? Although magkapareha sila ng tinatawag nating self-discipline. Kasi kailangan mo ng discipline eh. But magkaiba yung intention. Ang intention, kapag nagda-diet tayo, on our personal reason or health reason. Pero kapag nag-fasting tayo, ang nakatuon tayo doon sa spiritual reason. May purpose ko kung bakit ka nag-aayuno o nagpa-fasting. Sapagkat para sa atin, para makapagdasal tayo ng mabuti. Makapag-focus tayo sa pagdarasal. Kasi mahirap po kung busog na busog tayo, kakakain mo lang, or ang laki ng, ang dami mo kinain, tapos magdarasal ka, aantokin ka. Kaya mas maganda rin po na nakapag-ayuno ka, nakapag-fasting ka. At least medyo bawas yung ating mga makamundo, hangarin. Focus tayo kung saan tayo para makapagdasal tayong mabuti. Naalala ko tuloy nung student brother kami, o student brothers kami, kapag malapit na yung Lenten season, meron na yung mga pag-aayuno o fasting kami. At sa fasting namin, hindi lang basta hindi kami kakain, pagdarasal, pero yung aming pondo para doon sa aming snacks na kakainin, eh, dino, iniipon po yun, tapos idodonate for a apostolate. Maaring sa apostolic group ibibigay. At doon mo marirealize, one time, yung aming naipon, naibigay namin doon sa scholarship program ng aming studentate. At nakakatuwa kasi yung ipon mo, may natulungan ka para sa iba. Sa ating ebanghelyo, narinig po natin yan, ano, napakahalaga para sa mga nagtatanong na mga pariseyo. Bakit daw mga alagad ni San Juan Bautista at mga pariseyo nag-aayuno? Samantalang itong mga alagad ng ating Panginoon, hindi sumusunod sa fasting o pag-aayuno. Alam niyo po kasi, nung taayim ni Jesus, ang mga Hudyo, meron silang once a week na fasting. At nagsisimula yan mula alas 6 ng umaga hanggang alas 6 ng hapon. So, ang matagal, ano? At yung mga striktong sumusunod sa fasting ay dalawang beses. Napag-alaman ko po na Monday and Thursday po ito. Ang ating Diyos po ay hindi against sa fasting o pag-aayuno. May dahilan ng ating Panginoon. Bakit niya sinabi sa mga pariseyo na ito na bakit hindi sila nag-aayuno? Kung babasahin natin, reading between the lines ng sagot ng ating Panginoon, kasi kasama pa nila si Jesus. Feasting, not fasting. Now, feasting, F-E-A-S-T. Parang piyesta muna bago mag-ayuno. Ito po kasi ang naging tradisyon. Nung time ni Jesus sa mga Hudyo, ang mga kinakasal, hindi agad-agad nag-honeymoon. Sila po ititira sa bahay nila. At isang linggo po yung fiesta. Isang linggong yung mga kamag-anak nila ay pupunta doon para makikain, mag-inuman, magsaya. Ganon sila kasi pag may kinakasal. At dahil nga po ang mga Hudyo, exempted ang mga kinasal sa fasting. Imaginin mo kung isang linggo kang mag-feast tapos may isang araw na fasting. So mapuputol yung kasiyahan. Kailangan dire-diretso yan. Kaya ganun po ang nangyari. Kaya ang sagot ng ating Panginoon, mag-aayuno lang ang mga apostol o mga alagad ng Diyos kapag siya'y umalis na. Ibig sabihin, after ng kanyang passion, death, and resurrection, saka pa lang sila mag-aayuno. Pero habang kasama nila ang Diyos, feasting muna tayo bago tayo mag-fasting. Kasiyahan muna tayo bago tayo mag-ano. Kailangan muna mag-enjoy at i-enjoy ng mga apostol ang presensya ng Diyos. Iyon po ang naging sagot ng ating Panginoon. Kasama pa nila ang bridegroom. Kaya alam niyo po ang naging conclusion ko dito. Kapag natagpuan natin si Jesus sa ating buhay, bagamat yung mga apostol, kino-question yung kanilang pagpa-fasting, hindi pa naman sila totally prepared for that, no? Bukod doon sa sila ay exempted dahil kasama pa nila si Jesus. Natagpuan din ang mga alagad. Nakita ko rin po, pag natagpuan mo si Jesus sa buhay mo, you will find happiness. But itong happiness na ito, hindi naman ito yung wala ka ng problema, puro ka na lang saya. Hindi po. Pwede ka rin maging masaya in the midst of your problems, struggles, and challenges. Basta kasama mo si Jesus, you will find happiness. Hindi mo yan makikita sa mga yung kasiyahan or happiness sa power, position, and money. Only in God. Kaya you will find happiness only in God. Please stand for the prayers of the faithful. Let us pray to God, our Father, that He may bring us closer to the values of the gospel, to renew the church and the world. For every petition, we shall say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the church, the people of God, and its leaders may follow the promptings of the Holy Spirit to speak to the people of today the ever new language of the gospel. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are invested with executive, legislative, and judicial functions in society may constantly place the good of human beings above legalistic concerns. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
that we may open our hearts to God's saving power in Christ, which is much more important than observing an ancient religious practice. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may become channels of the Lord's caring hands to the sick by showing them love and concern. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our Pope, the College of Bishops, parents, relatives, benefactors, and for all those whom we promise to pray. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Master of the Order and his assistants, and for our brothers and ministry at Santo Domingo and Our Lady of the Rosary of Manaoag. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions of the devotees and pilgrims of Our Lady of the Rosary of Manaoag, and for our personal intentions. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dead may find eternal rest in the company of the risen Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, hear our prayer and teach us the art of living as new people set free by the love of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. Please stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries. For whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for in goodness you created man, and when he was justly condemned, in mercy you redeem him through Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exaltation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim.
palang kapahirito sa ngala ng Panginoon. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna sa kaitaasan. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna sa kaitaasan.
Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Sa kruso at pagkabuhay, kami natubos mong tunay. O Jesus, naming mahal, iligtas mo kaming tanan. O Jesus, aming mahal, ngayon at magpakailanman.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Socrates our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. 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 Amen.
Please all stand.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil. Amen. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer
each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Blessed be the Lord, for he has come to his people and set them free. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel, he has come to his people and set them free.
He has raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of his servant David.
Through his holy prophets he promised of old that he would save us from our enemies, from the hands of all who hate us.
He promised to show mercy to our fathers, and to remember his holy covenant.
This was the oath word to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight all the days of our life.
You, my child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins.
In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Blessed be the Lord, for he has come to his people and set them free.
Let us pray. Pour on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness make those who have nourished by this one heavenly bread, one in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Tayo po ngayon ay magbe-bless ng mga may sakit. Ganon din po ang inyong mga dalang rosaries and other religious articles. Pwede nyo na po ilabas yung inyong mga dalang rosaries and other religious articles. Sa mga naka-online po, pwede po kayong sumabay sa amin para sa panalangin, para i-bless po ang mga may sakit po. God, our Almighty Father, by your blessing, you give us strength and support in our frailty. Turn with kindness toward our sick brothers and sisters. Free them from all illness and restore them to good health. Through the intercession of Our Lady of the Rosary of Manaoag, so that in the sure knowledge of your goodness, they will gratefully bless your holy name. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Prayer for the blessing of rosaries and other religious articles. In memory of the mysteries of the life, death, and resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, and to the honor and glory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of Christ, Mother of the Church, Our Lady of the Rosary of Manaoag, may these rosaries, images, candles, oil, and other religious articles be blessed and made holy in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.